Let's learn practically about report breakings in business objects. As we know, means breaking is a kind of a grouping of the data based on the different dimensions so that we can view the data in the measures based on the dimensions available. So basically, if you say sometimes the requirement for the reports is kind of we need to display state and city and then their sales revenue. So this is an example where suppose user might want to see this state-wise, city-wise sales revenue. So basically how we apply as a manual or static breaking is like this. So we just go this and add breaks. So from here means we can specify this is state and city. But what happens means if you have some requirement like user wanted to see the breakings based on his choice. So suppose there is a prompt which is available in the report and we can say user wanted to say the sales revenue by city or maybe by state as well. So suppose he selects state as an answer to the reporting break, then we can see the results get changed to state wise revenue. So this is this they wanted to see maybe. So this is on the left side, you can see this is static breaking where state and city wise breaking is applied. And on this we can see this is state wise breakings. So we can change it. So based on the user prompt which is selected, as suppose this is being selected as state, then this breaking will get changed to state-wise revenue. So you will see these are the state names. So this is the kind of structure breakings we can apply based on the user selection. So how this can be achieved? So let's see. To achieve this, we need to create LOVs and prompts as well. So the first step is create an LOV. So let's create an LOV so that which can be available to display in the prompt. So let's say this is reporting break and the prompt which you wanted to display is like this state and city. What are the options? Means we can have many options available here based on our requirement. And then we can have this as so name as reporting break. Now once we the first step is creating a static list of values. Once we create this, then we need to create list of we need to create a report parameters, so which can be used to display in the report. So let's create it as a reporting break. Let's say reporting breaks as a prompt name. Then we can select it as a reporting. So this is a prompt text which is available here, a reporting break. And one more thing important, we need to select as allow multiple values. So we cannot have this allow multiple values, otherwise this will not work. So always uncheck this option. Then associate list of values. So whatever the list of values we just created, we will create this as a list of values which we have just created, and just assign this to this. And then we can set some default values if you want. By default we can select any of this value which is as per user requirements. So this is the first step we have created. Now the second step in the business layer itself, we can create another objects which is required for prompt display. So we can say it as reporting breaks, and here we can specify it as the prompt which we have just created. So this is fine, means you can just select this and then you can validate. Now once we have created this prompt, if you click on the show values, it will prompt for state and city. So this is the prompt which you wanted to in the report. So this is the first step we create. The second step we create a parameter, And then for dynamic selection, we need to create another object which is related to the reporting breaks dynamic. So which will just make that user's selection as it's a reporting breaks dynamic. You can give any name for this. And here we will write a case statement for this case. And this is the prompt which we are having now. We can write as Wednesday, and if it is Wednesday, then we can select this objects as which is on what objects we wanted to select. So this is a state we wanted to select these objects. When it is city, then we wanted to select city object. And else, if it is not else, then we can say it is unexpected answer, something like that, and we can just validate this. So once we have this, so the main thing is we can this is the prompt which we are going to add in the report, and what are the answer which is provided for this prompt based on this choice of the user which is making. If it is state, then we are selecting its respective objects, which is state objects. If it is city, then it is selecting as a city object, or else means unexpected. So once we have created these objects, so now we have created these objects, how we can use this in the report. Now let's create a report, or let's publish this universe first. So we'll just create another report which is based on this prompts. So now once we have created these objects, dynamic objects, we just need to add these objects in the our report, and then we can make it available as a reporting dynamic breaks. So let's do it how we can do it. Let's create a new report. So we have this state, city, and sales revenue. So suppose if you just run this query, and now we are not having any prompts, we are not setting any prompts here. So we'll just get in a report which just says this state is, and so to manually, if you wanted to add this, then just as a static break, suppose we wanted to have a break on this, and let's add this as a add break. And if you wanted to have a static as another sit a break on the city as well, then we can have it a break. So now if you see in this manage breaks option, on this you have state and city. So basically this is a static breaking which just says, but we don't want to have a static. It depends upon the user selection what they wanted to see it. So let's do it. I'm just removing these breaks now. So we have this we wanted to have a reporting breaks which selects statics ones. Now let's go to the query, and the objects which we have created, just add it. So this is an object which is for dynamic breaking, and this is another object which is for reporting break. So once we have this objects added, we will get a prompt to be asked as reporting breaks to city and state. And if you just select equal any of this value, right now it will not change any breaking on this, though we have added the prompt. To change this prompts, what we need to do is instead of these objects, let's add an objects which we have just created here. let me delete this column. Now you will see this is basically based on this prompt has been changed. Now because I have selected state, now if I select as a state, this value will get changed and this will display the cities. Yep. So it depends upon the user response value. Let's say here you can space. So if you select a state, so this column will get changed. State wise the sales revenue will change. Now we wanted to add a break, so how we can add the breaks? So to add the breaks, we can just right click on this and say as add breaks. So now this has been changed, so state wise revenue breaking has been changed. Now if I make this as city, this will change. So city wise value will be changed and this will be the revenue will be displayed based on the city. So this is the breaking which is applied. So there are other options about breakings as well which we can change as well. So suppose we don't want to have a display as just to look better, we don't want to see the footer, then we can make it as a like this and we can have it. So we select state, the breaking will change based on the state. So this is how we can achieve the break dynamic breaking. Basically the thing is about this case statement where we can apply this based on the prompts answer, select the appropriate objects, and then once we have this, the next step is just to get that objects in the reports and just add dynamic breaking as add breaks. So this will make dynamic breaking. So this can be possible with the dynamic sections as well. We can do the same thing with the sections as well. We can do have the case statement for section where we can section the report based on different users selections. So this way this dynamic reporting report breaking is possible, and I hope this would be helpful for you in performing dynamic report breakings. And if you have any questions, then please put it in comment section, and if you like my video, then please like it and subscribe to my channel as well. Thank you for watching.